Now, Hawaii's most accurate weather with Kelly Simek.
Aloha and happy Aloha Friday, everybody. Setting up to be a very rainy day today. Of course, we're already seeing the impacts from Eric spreading across the state. Now, we just got the 11 a.m. update from the National Hurricane Center and the Central Pacific Hurricane Center. Both of these systems have weakened. Of course, we have Tropical Storm Eric, and just behind it on its heels, Tropical Storm Flossie, which, taking a look at the satellite, you can really see Flossie's become a bit more disorganized. You definitely see some weakening with the system on the imagery here. Now, let's take a look at what we're seeing at the moment, because again, there's a lot of convection near the island chain and a lot of rainfall and cloud cover is spreading over us, as well as this deep tropical moisture from Eric continues to pull over the state. Now, because of the consistent heavy rainfall that we've been seeing, we do have plenty of watches, warnings and advisories in place. Still expecting a lot more rainfall from the system. The strong winds will continue with us, and we're still looking at large surf through at least early Saturday. Now, starting Sunday is when we're really going to be monitoring Flossie as it nears, but it looks like those main impacts are going to be starting on Monday. Here's Eric, though. Take a look. The 11 a.m. update does have this weakening a bit. Current sustained winds at 45 miles an hour. It's forecast to maintain tropical storm strength as it clears the state, but this update actually does have it weakening from a tropical storm a little bit earlier as well, just as it clears the state. But again, still going to be seeing big impacts from this in the coming days. Currently, a flash flood watch is in place for Hawaii Island. Still have a flood advisory in effect for the southeast portion of the island. Tropical storm warning for the waters south of Hawaii Island. Wind advisory continues for Maui County and Hawaii Island. Boaters, small craft advisory in effect. Still looking at a high surf warning for the eastern shores of Hawaii Island and a high surf advisory for most south and eastern shores of the smaller islands. All right, well, again, we're currently seeing the impacts of Eric, but Flossie is going to be next. Take a look. Good news is we're finally seeing some weakening. Late last night, Flossie actually re-strengthened a little bit, but currently winds at 65 miles an hour. So still a very powerful tropical storm, but at least we are seeing weakening. Now, take a look. That line that you see right here, that's the 140 mark. So this 11 a.m. update was the last update from the National Hurricane Center. Central Pacific Hurricane Center is going to be taking over because this is crossing into our waters in the next couple of hours. Now, take a look. The system is forecast to continue to track further west before hooking up to the northwest. And we do have forecast models coming into very good agreement that we're not looking like we're going to be seeing a direct impact from this, or at least a direct landfall. Still impacts, but as you can see, there's still a couple of those rogue forecast models that do have this a little further to the south, but most of those have this kicking north. And as we've gotten a little bit closer, that's continued to be the consensus. So as you can see, the official track from the National Hurricane Center does not have any of Hawaii in that cone of uncertainty, which means we're not expecting a direct landfall. So that's good news. Now, I measured out between Hawaii Island and the tropical storm as it passes to our north. It looks like we're going to be seeing this about 150 to 200 miles to the northeast of us. And as that does track away, take a look at how weak it is. Just as it's to the northeast of Hawaii Island, we're looking at winds at just 40 miles an hour. That's barely a tropical storm. Once it is below 39 miles an hour, it will no longer be one. So that's good news. We're continuing to see this weaken as it approaches us, still expecting impacts, but the weaker the better, of course, in terms of the wind speeds, as well as the impacts that we're going to be seeing overall. Now, regardless, it does look like we're going to be seeing impacts. As of right now, we're looking at heavy rainfall still coming through, and forecast models still show this a little bit more widespread across the state, even more so than what we were seeing in the forecast models with Eric. Strong winds going to be coming through. Winds definitely going to be different with this system, with it passing to the north of us, and of course, the high surf. Now, talking about those winds, as it passes to the north of us, and typically when we do see any low pressure systems to our north, it's not a good sign, because that means trade winds are shut off, humidity levels are high, and it does look like we're going to be seeing a little bit of a southerly flow taking over that brings up that moist tropical air from the tropics. So be prepared for that. The humidity expected to be on the rise, but a lot of rainfall as well. And speaking of the rainfall, let's take a look at the future satellite and radar. First, we have Eric here, which is continuing to pass away from us. Again, still expecting rainfall, but the bulk of the heaviest of the showers, the bulk of the moisture is going to be remaining to the south and with the center of that storm. Now, as it kicks up to the northwest, let's take a look at Flossie. Now, the model that we're looking at right now is the ECMWF, and as this approaches, you can see Flossie starting to approach some widespread heavy showers with this system. This, when it became a little bit more widespread, we just saw the forecast model shift to the GFS because that is going out a little bit further in our graphics. So this is what we're expecting now by Tuesday at 6 a.m. as this thing continues to lift to the northeast. So let's try to play that once again as we progress this along through, again, Eric going to continue to clear the state as Flossie approaches. We're going to expect to start to see some impacts potentially late Sunday, but it's looking like this really approaches and gets closer early Monday. But this is a look at 11 p.m. on Sunday. Again, we're going to shift to the GFS right now. And as this tracks to the north, we see it then hook up, still lingering moisture and still spreading moisture across the entire state, but not looking like a direct landfall. And if you just saw as well, if you were paying attention to the wind contours, we did see a nice little southerly flow take over. But it's looking like starting Wednesday for portions of the state, namely especially Hawaii Island, and starting for Maui County, it looks like those trade winds would then be returning. But as you can see, definitely some variability. And we have those light and variable winds, that's when it can really become humid. So expecting slightly different impacts with this, but again, the main thing is looking like rainfall, wind, and then also the large surf. With the wind, actually with all the impacts, it's really going to depend on the eventual track and intensity. It's still too far out to know the exact impacts, but if it continues on this trend that it is, that's mainly what we're going to be looking at. But make sure you stay with KHON2. We'll continue to give you the latest on air and online, and download our KHON2 mobile app. We'll be sending you out push alerts with everything you need to know about, well, both systems, but especially now looking forward as we continue to track Eric, also Flossie, in the coming days. But with Eric, we're still going to be seeing impacts in the coming days. Hopefully everyone grabbed their umbrellas as they were heading out the door this morning, because although the impacts mainly on the Big Island, we're definitely seeing a lot more of that rainfall spreading across the smaller islands as well.